So this may look like a large tablet, something like an iPad, but it's actually a photo frame. So this is Dragon Touch Digital Photo Frame Classic 15. This is a 15.6 inch screen. So in today's video, I'm going to do an unboxing of this, and then we will take a look at all the features that this digital photo frame offers. So I think this is a pretty good companion device for your workspace, like your home office or your office, where you can keep this digital photo frame as opposed to having, you know, traditional pictures. And obviously it's a digital photo frame, so you can have lots of pictures. It comes with 16 gig of internal storage, and it also has an external SD card slot, and there is a USB slot for adding a USB stick. So let's open it up. Looks like a giant slab. It's 15.6 inch. This looks like a portable, you know, external monitor. It's about an inch thick. The back also has these screws for mounting it. So you also get this handy dandy remote, and this is going to be really useful if you plan to install this picture frame on the wall. Of course, you are getting the cables and you get a wall charger. Okay, next is this stand. This is basically a circular thing. It comes with a screw. You attach it to the back of the frame, and then you can, you know, keep the picture frame on your desk. So here is how your homepage is going to look. And so this is basically running as, you know, modified version of Android, but you're not getting all the features of an Android tablet. Obviously, this is a picture frame, but they are still giving you a lot of information. So I like the fact that, as you can see here, when you set up the device, you can enter your city and it will give you the weather information, which is really nice. And it will also have a slideshow of all the pictures that you have uploaded. So they will run here. You get the forecast. So for here in Northern California, where I live, you know, it's clear today, probably cloudy tomorrow. So that's handy. It's a touch interface, so no physical buttons, which is again a good thing. And you also get a calendar here. Now, this is not synced with Google Calendar, so that's, you know, a negative. You can't also make an entry. So if you want to set up something, an event or something, you won't be able to. But it is good for just looking, you know, what day of the week. Today is Friday, for example. So that's not bad. Again, you will have a picture slide running here, which is kind of cool. Let's go back to the home page. Now, you also have a video tab here. And this is really nice because a lot of picture frames only allow you to watch pictures, but here you can actually watch video. And this is a nice 15.6 inch, really bright IPS display. So this is fantastic for watching videos. So I uploaded a couple of my videos that I, you know, uploaded on YouTube. So I put them in the SD card, and the SD card is, you know, I have, as you can see here, right? So you have the internal storage, which is 16 gig, and right now it's empty. And I have an SD card here where I have put these videos. So let's watch this video. It's pretty cool actually, so, right? You can load your movies in this, and you can use this screen to watch movies. You can't stream anything, unfortunately. Let me pause it. But whatever you load in the SD card, you will be able to watch it, which is, I think it's pretty cool. Now let's go into the pictures. So right now I don't have a whole lot of pictures. I just put some of the pictures I shot from my phone. So these are not high quality pictures, but this is how it will look. So if you don't do anything, it will just go in a slideshow mode and it will just keep playing this, which is really nice. So these are 4:3 aspect ratio pictures. So, and now this one is a 16:9. So it fills up the whole screen. And by the way, the 4:3 aspect ratio pictures also you can punch in. It does allow you to zoom in. So if you double tap, you can zoom in and you can zoom out. So that's nice. Now let me go back to the picture, which was, so for example, this picture, this is 4:3 aspect ratio. So you see the borders, right? So here is an option to make it 16:9. So it just zooms in and fills up the screen. So you can set it up like that if you want. So I want to see the whole picture, so I will go back to 4:3. And here you have basic control options, pause, and you can delete. You can also set up the, you know, background music and slideshow interval and all that. So pretty nice actually. Now the brightness, it's not full right now, and I have these harsh lights in the studio where I'm recording this. So that might make it look like not very bright, but trust me, this is a pretty bright screen for, of course, you won't be using this outdoors, right? But for indoor home office use, this is a really bright screen, and the brightness right now is not even full. So if I go back to home, so you can go to display, and here I am, this is the full brightness. Okay, so let's take a look behind here. So you have controls here, right? You can see an SD card, and then you also have a USB stick, so you can put like a USB stick to expand storage. There is a headphone jack. If you are watching videos, you can connect that and, you know, listen to the audio. And you have a charging cable, and then there is a USB. This is a micro USB slot for connecting this to your PC if you want to transfer pictures, you know, using USB. Now, this is a simple stand that you get, but like I showed in the unboxing, there is also a wall mount. So you can attach that clamp and then mount it on the wall. And it does come with a remote control, so you can use the remote control to then operate the device. But yeah, if you wall mount it in your living room, for example, you can set it up in the automatic picture mode, right? Slideshow, and then it will just keep playing pictures of your family or whatever, vacation pictures or whatever you want to watch. Okay, so going back to home screen, as you can see, you have an option for an alarm, which is really handy. So if you have this picture frame in your bedroom, for example, you can set up your alarm here, and you will be able to, let's see what options it gives you. So you can, it's a very, very basic alarm, right? You have repeat option, you have bunch of ringtones, and you can set up your alarm. So neat feature. Let's go back and let's go in the settings now. You get a device ID, and that's your unique identifier for this device. I want to hide that because I don't want you guys to broadcast photos on my device. So let's go to user maintenance now. And here you can add users. So whoever is authorized, those people will be able to send pictures to this device. You will have to install an app, and the app is available for both Android and iOS. So I have not set that up yet, but you can have more than one user, and then they will be able to send pictures to this screen. You also have a very nice feature here. So this is FTP. So Batman is my, you know, home user ID. And all my Wi-Fi, you know, they are all named after DC superheroes. So right now I'm connected to Batman. Now, if you enable FTP server, so if you click on it, it gives me a IP address. Now, of course, the IP address that you will get will depend on your home network. But this is a unique IP address for this device. And now from my PC or from my tablet, I can install a FTP client. There are a bunch of free FTP clients that you can install on Windows. And then using those, you can then transfer pictures and videos from your computer or your laptop, you know, your tablet or your phone to the device using FTP. So I think this is really nice. This is a kind of a hidden gem of a feature. Most of the other devices, I have not seen this. This is kind of a geeky thing. A lot of people don't know about FTP. But once you set it up, it's very easy. Just drag and drop, and you can, you know, move pictures and videos from your device to the screen. So that's cool. Let's go back. Wi-Fi, like I said, you can connect to your home network. You have Batman and Hulk here. So let's go to album settings. So here you have a bunch of options for how the photo will be displayed. You have a slideshow option. You can select 2 minute, 5 minute, you know, whatever time interval. And then you can have the description of the picture. You can have a background music also. These have built-in speakers, by the way. So it will play music, and the speakers are also used for, you know, when you're watching video. So that's it for today, guys. This was a short video. I think this is a really handy device for your home office, or, you know, even if you guys are actually going to office, like I'm working from home, but wherever you are working, you can keep this right next to your computer. It will show pictures, you know, your family vacation photos and other stuff. And it's nice to take a look at these things, like look away from your computer screen and look at something which is more pleasant, right? So I will drop a link to this in the video description below. And that's it for today, guys. Thanks for watching this video, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye.